This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. On this video, we're going to find the exact values of each expression, all six of these, and we're going to write our answers as real numbers, which means you're not going to write your answers in degrees. It'll be written as a real number, so it might have a pi in it, etc. All right, let's start with the first one. The inverse cosine of negative square roots of 3 over 2. What does that mean? You're trying to find an angle in quadrant 1 or 2 where the cosine is negative square roots of 2, right? Because the inverse cosine is between 0 and pi. That's in between quadrant 1 and 2. And for the cosine to be negative, we must be talking about something in quadrant 2. So you could memorize these answers. I usually don't do it. But if it's negative, I'm going to think of this as the ratios of the sides, negative square roots of 3 over 2. So to me, this is how I draw it. I think of this as negative square roots of 3. That's your x over your r. And then I recognize this as the special triangle here, right? The 30-60-90 triangle. And you can either think of this in terms of degrees or radians, but you have to write your answer in radians. So this is at 150 degrees or 5 pi over 6. Okay, so our answer, written as a real number, will be 5 pi over 6. If you think in terms of degrees, which is how I usually do it, I think of this as the 30 degrees right here. All right? So I know this is all the way over to pi is 150 degrees. So, is 180 degrees. So that means up to here would be 150 degrees. So that's how I would get that. And then you can convert 150 degrees to radians, which is a real number, and get 5 pi over 6. All right, let's do the second one. You've got the arc sine of 1, same idea. So where is the arc sine defined? That's between negative pi over 2 and pi, or if you think in terms of degrees, between negative 90 and positive 90. And where is the sine going to be 1? Well, let's see. Let's look at right on the axis. This is 0, negative 1. This is 1, 0. And this would be up at 0, 1 if I think about the ordered pairs on the unit circle. And so I want to know where is the sine of what angle gives me 1. In other words, what's the y coordinate on the unit circle? And it would be right here, 1. That's up at 90 degrees, right? So we're talking about this angle here. Or since we are asked to write our answer in radians, that would be pi over 2. Okay, arctan is 0. Now we're trying to find where the tangent is 0. So if you want to think about it this way, you're saying the tangent of my answer, right? I don't know what the answer is. Tangent of x has got to be 0, really. But just like the arc sine, the arc tangent is between negative pi over 2 and pi. So remember how tangent is defined. It's the y over the x on the unit circle, or if you even had a right triangle as well. So I have to figure out where is that going to happen. So you could think of this as 0 over 1. So you're trying to find which ordered pair here is going to give me 0 over 1, where y is 0 and x is 1. So do you see it? It's right here. 0 over 1, that's at 0 degrees or 0 radians. So the arctan of 0 is 0 because the tangent of 0 is actually equal to 0. Here's another one, arctan. Again, it's, disappeared on me. Again, we're looking where the tangent of an angle is negative 1 over root 3. Now you got to be careful here. When you see, you might see this as written as tangent, arctangent of negative root 3 over 3. If you see that, some people get confused. They don't recognize that as a special, value from a special angle. But actually, if you rationalize the numerator, it would look like this. 1 over root 3 with a minus sign. In any case, just keep in mind that you might see it written a little bit differently. And the arctangent, or the inverse tangent, is in between negative, the answer has to be in between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. So again, it's over here. And for it to be negative, it's got to be in the quadrant 4 down here, right? And remember, you don't write something bigger than pi over 2. It has to be written as a negative angle in this case, or a negative real number, because we're going to write it as a real number. So tangent again is y over x. Okay, well, over in quadrant 4, let's see, x's are always positive and y's are always negative. So when I see that negative 1 over square roots of 3, remember that's y over x, right? The tangent is y over x. The y is negative, so the numerator is where I have to think of, in this case, negative 1, where the denominator can be thought of as a positive square roots of 3. So I'm going to draw an angle here where y is negative 1 and x is square root of 3. If you haven't memorized it, like I don't memorize any of these. So if this is square root of 3 and that's negative 1, there's my angle right here. Now the angle is going down, okay? It's a negative angle. I've drawn an angle where the tangent is negative 1 over square roots of 3, right? And what angle is that? Well, that's negative 30 degrees if you want to think of it in terms of degrees, or negative pi over 6. If you need to do your conversion each time, that's perfectly fine. So I get negative square roots of, I'm sorry, so it's negative pi over 6 for our answer. Okay, arc cosine of negative 1. Alright, so now we want where the cosine is negative 1. Now, remember, it's only the arc cosine that is defined between 0 and pi. Both the arc sine and the arc tangent, it's between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. So now we're looking for an angle or a real number in quadrants 1 to 2. And we want the cosine to be negative 1, right? The cosine of that angle. Our real number is negative 1. So if I'm on the unit circle, here are the order pairs for those quadrants. And where's the cosine negative 1? In other words, where is the x coordinate? Negative 1, it's right here. And that is pi units. So the arc cosine of negative 1 would be pi units. Now this last one's a little tricky. I said sine inverse or inverse sine of 0.5. You think, what? Just make it into a fraction. So that's just the same thing as 1/2, right? Okay, anytime it's positive, when you're doing these, you know you're in quadrant 1. So we're looking for something in quadrant 1 where the sine is 1/2, and that would be right here. Right? So this is square root of 3, and hopefully you recognize that angle. That's pi over 6, or 30 degrees if you've written in degrees. We're asked to write everything in terms of real numbers, so our answer is pi over 6. So there's several examples finding the arc cosine, the arc sine, or the arc tangent. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.